Welcome to Miami, 47. The innovation race is on its last day, and it is down to the wire. Thousands of eager fans are gathered for the final laps of this unexpectedly close race. Sierra Knox is expertly piloting her red Kronstadt car. Her father, Robert Knox, roams the nearby expo building where Kronstadt is showcasing its new prototype car. The Kronstadt RK Mark III has seen fierce competition from the Chinese Kowloon Heavy Industries new racer. Moses Lee, CEO of Kowloon, has taken a dominant lead and looks invincible. The stakes are as high as they can get.
Sir, I will have to pat you down if you want to come through.
How much time remaining? Don't worry, folks. Anything can still
okay.
happen.
Thank you, sir. This will be over in no time. Okay, let's go, sir. Thank you.
Let me just repeat some ground rules for those of you new. You've got to cover as much of them as possible within the time frame. When the time's...
Oh, will you look at that? There's no holding back out there. The battle for positions going on into that corner. Boy, oh boy, that's some great racing out there. Moses Lee is tearing up the track. Endurance racing is to keep that car going until
the end.
About
your problems,
this
right?
race is not
they
over
clear
until
the sword
the clock ticks down.
Disengage and be off the Kronstadt team. Half an hour later, I have to listen to Knox berate my skills as a mechanic because the roll cage interferes with the radio signals from Sierra's suit.
No more.
I'm done. Yes, I know you're a man short now, and no, I don't give a rat's ass about it.
I'm looking forward to this about all of you.
Double my salary for the entire week. And I'll come
so
back in case Sierra decides to
last
use that last pit stop.
He'd want to do better this time around.
Well,
but I
you
wouldn't
decide
be surprised to see him
on
the podium
by the
at the end of the day.
Best of luck, Grace.
One of the Kronstadt pit crew has quit the team in protest, and Grace Miller, the ballbuster chief mechanic, is in critical need of a replacement. Why don't you step in and offer your services, 47? You're good with a wrench.
There is still plenty of time left, folks, and anything can happen. Let me just repeat some ground rules for those of you new to endurance racing. You've got to cover as much ground as possible within the time frame. When the time's up, we have our winner.
Hey.
was talking earlier. They said the car was behaving erratically. That last lap before the accident. You think anyone, you know, helped make the accident happen?
Wouldn't be the first time during these races.
Hey, Spannermuth! I just need to talk to you. Answer me when I'm talking.
Let me just repeat some ground rules for those of you new to endurance racing. You gotta cover as much ground as possible within the time frame. When the time's up...
Salutations, my friend.
Look, I'm in a deep hole. One of my guys just jumped ship and I need a replacement ASAP. Are you available? Shit! Alright, gotta run. Talk later.
Suppose
you,
I am.
Great, this is your lucky day. Do well and there's a bonus in it. Got it?
Got it.
All right, everyone, look alive and get to your stations. Sierra may come in for a last-minute pit stop, and I need you ready and able. You, rookie, get into position. Grab your preferred tool.
Excellent, 47. And now for a bit of maintenance.
Everyone on your stations, now!
Target down. Next up, Robert Knox.
What the hell just happened? Sierra!
Sort of vitamin hydration boost, normally reserved for the drivers. Fixed me right up.
What? Are you doping? No, it's for after the race. It's me.
I'm here now. Ready to meet up with Sierra Knox over at the hotel. Yeah, after the race. I've just got to pick up the documents from my van, but I had to knock out a guy and steal his flamingo outfit, and now I can't find my car keys. Yeah, I know it's dumb. I think I lost them in the scuffle, but the real mascot is still over there. If I don't get them, I've got no evidence. Bye-bye money. I don't know. I need to figure something out. I'll talk soon.
Too, you know. The fact is that Kronstadt is very likely withholding information on what actually happened in Tunnel Valley. And I think that people have a right to
know. Don't know. This is my first gig. Never been to any of these races before, but it sure is loud. I heard something about a secret demo upstairs in the expo building, but it's off limits apparently.
Yeah, Robert does.
It's a beautiful vehicle, that's for sure. I understood from the briefing earlier that we're just supposed to grab him if something happens to it.
No poking around the engine or anything like that.
Yeah, Knox is a genuine technical genius. He's really protective about his projects. Prefers to fix everything himself, apparently. Don't worry about grabbing him. If anything goes awry, you'll see him down here as fast as lightning.
Gotcha.
Robert Knox has a race car on display in the Expo building. The show staff is under strict instructions to summon him at any sign of malfunction. Apparently, Knox trusts no one to fix his car but him. Perhaps it's time to poke around under the hood, 47. They do say one should never mess with another man's wheels.
Hi.
Octane booster, huh? What is that stuff anyway?
I think some of the teams are using it to increase car speed. Heard a few Cronkite engineers talking about it the other day.
Really?
Good. I dare say this should get Knox's undivided attention.
Huh. That's the engine off. Let's just try to get this started again. Well, that doesn't sound good. Better call Knox. Mr. Knox? Yeah, it's Smith from down at the Expo. Listen, the Mark III's making some, well, just odd noises.
Can you come?
Great. All right. Yeah, I'll be here.
Someone's been tampering with the car. Heads will roll. I need you to get in the car. Don't touch anything until I tell you. It shouldn't behave like this at all. Try the engine, Smith. All right, try it now. This should work.
Targets down. Well done, 47. Head for an exit, and we'll speak again soon.
Berlin, Shanghai, Montreal. We're bleeding operatives. Panic is spreading, and now we are axing our own?
Knox was a traitor. He would have caused incalculable damage.
And he won't be the last. This is exactly what the enemy wants. We need to fight the sickness, not the symptom.
And I have just the tool for the job.
Right. The Burnwood woman. Eric Soders warned you about her, didn't he? The Crusader.
I can handle Miss Burnwood. Everyone hates power until you offer them some.
You ought to know.
ICA speaks the enemy's language. We need them.
And once we don't?
We'll cross that bridge when we get there.
Fact remains, we are shadowboxing. We need to know who we are up against.
I was getting to that. His name is Lucas Gray, the late Mr. Cobb's head of security. Cobb was ground zero, first of our operatives to die. It had to be one of his staff, someone with military training and access to the plane.
Grasping at straws.
Gray is a mercenary, a veteran of every backwater tragedy you've ever ignored on the 5 o'clock news. Chechnya, Sierra Leone, the list goes on. But before 89, nothing. No records of any kind.
Now, come on. CIA, KGB, plenty of spies went dark.
After the curtain was lifted, I cast a very wide net. Lucas Gray simply does not exist.
If you're all quite done wetting yourselves with excitement, I couldn't give two shits where he came from. I only want to know one thing.
How does he know about us?
I swear to God, this hearts and flowers crap will get us both killed. Can't you see? Your so-called friend is working for them now. He's not the man you knew.
This is his fight too, Olivia.
Even if he doesn't realize it. Like it or not, 47 is our last and only lead on the partners. He needs to remember.
He's coming for us. And unlike you, he won't hesitate.
Just get me inside. Rico, I need a favor.